Hello, hello, and welcome. This is functional fitness training. So today we're gonna have a special edition-ish, just focusing a little bit more on kettlebells. So if you have that, I would recommend maybe two light ones and one heavy one. If you don't got all of that, that's great, because good news, you can do everything we're doing today with a dumbbell. So mostly weighted, longer sets, and we'll go all into the reasons why you may want to use a kettlebell versus a dumbbell. I have a lot of people ask me, what's the difference between a dumbbell and a kettlebell anyways? And is it just round? That's pretty much what we're going to talk about. So let's go ahead and do those arm swings. As usual, we're working the full body, but we are focusing a little more on legs and core today. Take your arms, go in a big arm circle. I'm just starting to have you move as I'm talking about today's format. And we do mobility up front. So today's mobility, let's go ahead and reverse it. Today's mobility is going to be upper body. So we already started with some of that with our big arm circles, and as well as wrists and hands, because kettlebell and a lot of kind of rotating movements with a kettlebell or dumbbell tends to get into the wrist. So we're going to warm those up. Great. Before we do that, we're going to start with our general warm up. So let's go ahead, stand on one foot and just give your leg a little bit of a swing. Oh. Trying to stay on top, that rib over hip movement is gonna be really important to give you some stability. So swing that leg, I'm gonna get the music started. Good to be here, good to be here. Ah, breathe in. And then other side. And then now, I know I've talked a lot already, but the format today is gonna be called kettlebell circuits. In my circuit style class, we have 3 to 4 exercises that we repeat 3 times. For 45 seconds each. So that's the good stuff today. Wrist, arm, mobility up front. And then we'll get into that timed circuit today. All right, let's take it to squats. Hips back, hinging on the hips. Trying to keep that chest up. And if you want, we're doing upper body mobility. So I'm gonna start warming that up now. Bring your thumbs back as you squat. There will be the tendency to want to drop. Use your lats. Anchor that in. Ah. And 4 more counts. And 3. And 2. Top of the mat. Let's step it back. Big stride. Keeping in mind with warming up the upper body, I call these cactus arms. You can keep them there as you lunge back. That will counterbalance all this we do every day. Elbows back, anchor the ribcage, alternate. Lunges. 4 more and 4. 3, 2. Stand tall, Frankensteins. Reach for the toe, standing nice and tall. In that beautiful hamstring lift while keeping that upper body up. Yes. That's gonna lengthen that whole backside of the body. 4 more and 4. We're gonna move side to side to lateral lunges. Ready, set, here we go. Big step to the side, bring it in. Other step to the side, no biggie. If you're cramped on room, these are good too. Lateral sways. If you want, team, go ahead and add that top arm reaching to the sky. So if you're someone where it feels wrist numbness or hand numbness, you got this nerve that runs down from your neck through the shoulders over here. So the more you loosen up this thoracic as you reach and stretch and lengthen, the better that will feel. And for those of you who don't feel that, that's great. Let's keep that away at bay and just open that chest. 4 more, 4, and 3, and 2. Last one. Everyone come, narrow squat, hold, feet together. Ah, we're gonna get the ankles warm as we do this. Stay low, take your hands, and let's go ahead. We're gonna do some wrist rolls. Remember mobility? I did it myself, shoulders back, wrist mobility. Go in a circle, elbows stay together, one direction. And we get that low squat. We're still working. And other direction now, wrist rolls, here we go. Explore the corners that feel comfortable. four and three, two, one. Shake it on out. Big lateral lunge. Come in here. Take that toe, point it forward. Top arm goes up and drag that elbow down. Here and here. So we got into the wrist. This gets into the upper back. Four more. Four. And three. Two. And one. Other side. Keep pointing front. Just come down and drop that hip into a lateral lunge. Nook that arm into the forearm, upper thigh. Reach on up, look on up. And now elbow drags back. Keep going. Want that chest lifted. Long, straight spine. Ooh. All right, four more here. Nice team. Two more. And last one. Okay, one that is a little more interesting today. This is called nerve flossing by a physical therapist term. I call it talk to the hand. So get your feet together. You're facing sideways. And what you're going to do is you're going to step away from the hand. So if I was facing you, this is how it looks. Here, palm out, flex position, step. You should feel a little kind of a tingle right under the armpit. Hold, and come back to it. If you had a wall, you could do it there. Four more times. Here we go. Four, nerve flossing. This is going to open up your chest, make any of those tingly wrists feel a little bit better. That's two. Try to hold it there for 3 seconds. Three, two, one. And last one. You can make it a big lunge. Good. Shake it out. Ooh, just even maybe feels different on that side. Shake it out. Other side. Talk to the hand. Now step it out. Hold. And coming back center. We do this for approximately 8 to 4 times. And you have the option, instead of stepping, to take it to a lunge. Four more times. Here we go. And four. Hold. Three. Make sure to breathe into it. Oh, feels different. Two. And one. Nice team. Coming down to the floor for some thoracic extensions. If you're standing, you can stay in a low squat and do it here, but let's inch it down if you're coming down. Walk into a plank, drop it to the knees, one hand on the floor, one hand on the back of the head. Elbow to elbow, elbow lifts. Setting it on up, thoracic quadruped extensions. Here we go. Elbow to elbow, press that bottom hand into the floor. Whoa. So this is getting into the wrist, upper back. Just great upper body mobility. Lead with the elbows, last time. Shake it out. Other side. Shake it out if you were squatting for that too. Hands under the shoulders, hands on back of the head, lengthen the spine, and here we go. Elbow to elbow. Elbow reaches to the top of the ceiling. Again, bottom hand pushes into the floor. And breathe in here. Let's go four more times, that beautiful reach. And four. Good, I'm just pivoting so you can see. Two. And last one. Hold and relax. Okay, team. Coming down to the floor, everyone, we're gonna do elephant stomps. Great for wrist flexibility and range of motion. So you're here on all four. Just stomp your hands as far as you can go in one direction without bending the elbows. Should feel comfortable. Maybe one more past that, give it a little bit more. Stomping like an elephant. Now go the opposite direction. Fingertips go front. Boom. So the palms are gently reaching towards the floor as you do this, kind of stretching those things that our tendons and everything that tends to flex, right? This is really good, getting that hold. Now let's do that one more time around. Stomp, stomp, stomp. If you're doing the standing, you can do it on here or table. And go around. Beautiful. Okay, now we're gonna flip it. You're gonna come and put your palm on the floor like this. Should feel like a good gentle stretch, no pain. Any zings, that means back off of it and shake your hands out. So let me come join you. Elephant stomps reverse. On all fours, gently. Let's do one hand at a time so you don't feel like you're anchoring down into it. Here, gently rotate. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Gently rotate. Stick that pinky out as you rotate. Gently rotate. Anything that feels good, go with it. Stay there a while. Now opposite direction. I know this is a little bit something we don't do often, so be cautious, right? Gentle exploration of the pressure that you're kind of putting on that wrist. Shake it out, other side. Wah, might even want to stir the pot as you go to the other side. Okay, one hand down, other hand on that front of the palm. Let's start there, walk it around, stick that pinky out. I'm gonna stand tall so you can see. There, keep rotating. I have numbness in this hand. Often happens because I'm on my phone all day with my thumb. And this stretch, that's what gets it for me. It gets it going away. So go the other direction. Explore, explore. And another good one, we won't do it today, is a massage of the thumb. That's a good one too. So all the phone handlers, you're doing great stuff right now to counterbalance that day in, day out phone usage. That tends to build over time. So gotta shake it out. Everybody shake it out. Beautiful work. Okay, we're gonna do a plank before we go into our circuit set. Plank elbows or hands, now that they're all warmed up. Starting here, we're gonna go for 30 seconds, team. So set it on up, on our marks, get set, and here we go. So elbows or hands, you're gonna lift one leg up if you want, then other leg. If you want, bird dog, woo, is an option. Things to note in this plank, because we're gonna be using it later. Note how the rib is slightly in front of the hip, right? So we're not completely flat here, just slightly in front of the hip, but we're also not sagging. This will be important during our deadlifts. 5 seconds to go, find that neutral. Not up here, not down here. 3, 2, 1. Woo, that wasn't a whole lot of time to spend exploring those different positions, but we'll get into it. Okay, let's get it, team. Kettlebells or weights, wrists are warm, so let's get in it. First one, hinge catch, something heavy. So I'm gonna always show the kettlebell first, and then I will show the dumbbell version second. You're grabbing that kettlebell, holding it here. The hands go from here to the bottom of the Mickey ears. I think of these as Mickey ears. So at the bottom, hinging, then slide your hands to the top. Looks like this. It is a hinge with your butt back, knees above the shin. Dumbbell friends, you're grabbing here, you're catching center. Here, catching center. 45 seconds to try that out. We're doing it 3 times, so let's try it together. On our marks, get set, here we go. So you're hinging into a deadlift, and then you're using that glute power to get that weight up to your chest. Let's do that again. Hinge, butt back, up. Elbows stay in the side. So you aren't throwing the weight. Your hands are sliding up and down, whether it's the dumbbell or kettlebell. Oftentimes, I'll see people do this, woo, where there's a little up and then catch. It's really a slide. Focusing on that wrist position will keep that nice and neutral for you when you're going heavy. Relax. Okay, team, one hand, one light weight. It is squat, asymmetric clean. Let's talk about it and try it out together in two, one. You got that kettlebell, that palm is facing back, and then it's going to the top of the shoulder. More about that later, because I'm catching up with my dumbbell friends. Here, curl on up. Palms back, inside curl. Asymmetric, all on one side. Play with it. Now, for my friends, let's talk about wrist positioning here. Here to here is a corkscrew, right? If you find your dumbbell is coming up and or your kettlebell is popping you, there, that means your body's going too far away from the butt. Your arm is going too far away. Corkscrew it straight up. Relax. That was side one. Let's play with side two. Same thing, dumbbell, kettlebell, whatever you're rocking. It's one medium to heavy weight. Ready, set, squat it down, and then get it up to shoulder height. Knees are coming slightly before. Mid body. Straight line up from the middle of the feet to the shoulder. That's a clean. It's called cleaning it. So, doing super slow demo, keep going. Remember that corkscrew. Your end position is called a rack position. Neutral wrist for dumbbells or kettlebells. This is called the wrist breaker. No one wants that. Not for Christmas, not for birthdays. Good, 3, 2, 1. Relax. Okay, bottom loaded windmill or top, wide feet, everyone. Medium weight, take your toes, point them in the opposite direction, and here we go. Hip hinges down, hip hinges up. So you're just pulling that hip towards the outside corner, and that weight is just shaving the thigh. This is oblique core work, and you gotta go pretty heavy to feel the obliques coming and turning on. Most people might feel it in their hamstring. That's good too, all right? Now, only if you wanted to, you could take a heavy weight and top load it at the same time. We'll try that round two if you want, okay? 3, 2, 1, relax. Other side, oh. Okay, whatever what you did on one side, you're trying to try it on the other. Press it into that bottom leg and go. Hip hinge back and hip hinge up. Again, you can see, this is a perfect example where a dumbbell versus a kettlebell, not much difference. The difference is the placement in the weight. A kettlebell has a center of gravity that's much more together. It allows for easier swinging. And the handle grip might be a little bit more instability on the shoulder, right? So keep that in mind as you go in to every single round, what you're going for today. 5 seconds, 3, 2, 1. You've seen everything in the first circuit. Let's do it again. Starts with hinge catch. Option to go heavier if you want. Hinging, catching up at the top. That begins in 3, 2, 1, and go, and go. Using that hip power to really drive that weight on up. If you're at all, you're feeling anything in the back, you can go OG classic deadlifts instead with one or two weights. In this one, the kettlebell makes a nice catch hold, but the movement is the same. 3, 2, 1, relax. Okay, remember asymmetric squat to shoulder height. I want this neutral wrist at the top. Dumbbell or kettlebell. On our marks, get set. Here we go, squat it. Center, get it up. Straight line up. Good. For those of you who are practicing the kettlebell the first time, there's a little bit of a bang up period where you're trying to find how to not make it flop over. Key thing, thumb back, draw straight up, elbow rocks under. Elbow under. Everybody elbow under. Now find that neutral wrist at the end of each round. Kettlebell is resting in that nook. 3, 2, One, other side. Okay, other side. For my dumbbell crew, I'm gonna demo the end points on that. What a way to get the cardio up. Ready, set, go. Weight drops between the legs, neutral wrist up. Not weight, slightly resting, not necessarily out here. Boom. That could get a little wristy for some. Some people prefer just a neutral bicep. So, cruise on in round two. Oh, on that second side. We got three movements. This is the second side on that second movement. And remember, the next one is that windmill. 5 more seconds to go. 3, 2, 1. Relax. Set it on up. If you would like to do a bottom and top loaded, there is an option for that. Or maybe you want to try top for the first time. Ready, set, here we go. Those of you who are trying top with me, extend that arm, straight arm, lat is packed down, and now hinge at the hip, nice long neutral spine, use that glute, come on up. You are pressing that arm all the way up in a neutral line as you hit, hinge. That hand is right above the head, right? In line with the head. 10 seconds to go. You could do this with kettlebell or dumbbell. 3, 2, 1, relax. The kettlebell makes it a little bit more unstable because it's round and it's kind of moving, yeah? Gotta have a neutral wrist for that. Ready, set, second side. Top load if you want, or jam on that bottom load. Careful if you're wearing a watch. Kettlebells are also called watch breakers. You might want to take that off if you have it. Good, nice long hinge, long spine. Neutral wrist, looks like, as you keep it on up overhead. Dumbbell friends, same thing. 5 seconds to go. 3, 2, 1, relax. Okay, that was round two. Going to the top for round three. It's gonna be fun. Hinge catch, going heavy. Ready, set, last round. Oh. Still driving that straight line between mid-shin and chest. This is where, if you want to dial up that pace, it is the time. 20 more seconds to go. Cardio, power. 15 seconds now. Get up to get right back down. Yes, yes. 5 more seconds, just like that. 3, 2, 1, relax. Asymmetric squat, okay? Keep fine-tuning that clean. Okay, let's dive in. 3, 2, 1, wrist back, wrist facing midline. Down and up, corkscrew the hand. Pouring out the water, pulling it in. Other key thing, kettlebells resting diagonally on the hand. Yeah, so not necessarily up here, but diagonally across, high to low, also cool. Yeah. 3, 2, 1, relax, other side. Okay, team. Big inhale, we begin third and final round. Ready, set, here we go. Down, bring it up top. Just having that corkscrew from high to low. Each side will be different. Fine tune in what feels good to you. 20 seconds now. Okay. low. This is leg power. 5 seconds to go till we hit that windmill. 3, 2, 1, and relax. Top only, bottom only, or both. Windmill, loaded on up. Wide stance, diagonal. On our marks, get set. Here we go, hip hinge. Lock out that top arm, straight arm, but soft. If the top arm and you're loaded tends to bend, it means one of two things, too light or too heavy. It is the Goldilocks. If that starts to bend, too light or too heavy, pack the lat down, adjust the weight accordingly. 10 seconds to go. 5 seconds now. 3, 2, 1. All right, other side. Ready to play Goldilocks on the second side. Gotta find it just right. Wide feet, top or bottom loaded. Ready, set, here we go. Straight long spine, straight long arm. Beautiful windmill team. Talk about full body. It starts to build, my goodness. Halfway, 20 seconds to go. We're gonna have a nice little bonus of a fun exercise called carries after this. 10 seconds to go. So I'm gonna ask you to get your really heavy weight coming up in 5, 3, 2, 1. Okay. Use this time to either get a sip of water, take a break, or if you want something that's active recovery, another reason why kettlebells can be fun is it allows for combining and doing things like farmer carries. Farmer carries target that side oblique to feel like you're working, usually about 20 to 30, maybe even 40% of your weight. Most of us don't have that. So use the heaviest weight you have, grab a sip of water. We're gonna do 30 second walks around the side. And if you want something more, keep that weight above, away from the body. Because when you keep it like out here, that's hard too. 30 seconds, let's start it up and go. Asymmetric farmer's carries, active recovery, no biggie here. But if that's something you wanna throw into your workouts as you're sipping, that could be good. And second side, here we go. Load it up, doubling up, dumbbells or not. Ugh. I already did my grocery run today. Ugh. I will say, I am pretty impressed. I have those big Costco bags, and I go to the store and I load them up, and every time, are you gonna be able to carry that? Kettlebell training, yeah. And set that down. Okay, that was just a little tidbit, a little dip in the toe of what a farmer's carry is, okay? Also called suitcase style. We're gonna continue on our circuit. Turkish get-up sit-ups, so we'll be on the floor. Kettlebell push-up, optional rows. So if you have your two light weights, dumbbells or kettlebells, put them at the top of the mat. And then we're gonna have a Z press, meaning kneeling or standing. It's just an arm press alternating. We're gonna go slightly heavier as long as that feels good for your shoulder to go overhead. If not, I recommend a tricep back. Let's talk about this all. I said a lot of things. Come join me on the floor. Turkish get-up sit-ups. You have one leg bent, one leg extended, one weight in hand. Same side as that straight leg, okay? What we're gonna do here, sitting on up, press that weight up to the sky, slowly roll back down. You can hold that weight here, or you can hold that weight center. Now, that's how you do it with the dumbbell. If you want to have that slight more instability, challenge through the wrist and the shoulder, kettlebell land, it's resting on the outside of that forearm. Some people do get bruises from going heavy here. Just be mindful of that. there is a little bit of a period where your body got to get used to it. Just like volleyball, you ever played, you get banged up in the beginning. That's the first one. Second one, you can do this with dumbbells. You can do this with weights. Now, the bigger, heavier kettlebells will be a little bit more stable, but you're right on top of that kettlebell. If you feel more comfortable, do one side, row, then switch it to the other side, row. It is a plank row. Option to do a push-up here. So you're on two, plank row, boom, ah. That adds a little bit of tiltiness, which is the core challenge. So swap it to the dumbbell, or maybe you have a round dumbbell and that's already a challenge, up to you. Now, at the bottom, row, row, do a push-up, option knees or toes, okay? Demanding on the wrist, so let yourself know where you're going with it. Third and final exercise is gonna be a Z press here. One side, other side. Kind of classic, not too full body, but a little bit because you're stabilizing, okay? All on the floor, let's start with the sit-ups. Grab a weight, any weight, on our marks, 40 seconds. I gotta adjust one cycle, and go. So if you are marking it with me, same side as the leg extended, push it up, roll it on down. Keep reaching to the ceiling and stay right underneath that weight. Underneath right here. That's my recommendation. Whatever weight you're going with, you want that straight line from wrist to hip, right? If it's way out here in front of you, too light or too heavy. This is the Goldilocks scenario. Just right. You might have some shoulder mobility to work on, so maybe hold that weight center. Relax. Other side. Other side. So again, recapping on saying safe here. You're all the way out here, too light or too heavy. Still not working, hold it center. On our marks, get set. Here we go. Roll it down and up. Straight line. Straight arm. Breathing, good. Or rocking it here to concentrate on that core strength. Beautiful work. Try to go slow, limiting that momentum and just going for strength. 3, 2, 1. Find your plank row position option. You can always row up here if you're going for less wrist flexion. I'm gonna set myself up here and start on my knees. Ready, set, here we go. Row, row. Maybe you add a push-up. Boom, boom. Again, row, row, push up. If you are higher because of the weight, you will have a choice to make at the bottom of that push up, where to stop. So I say neutral, where that elbow is in line with that shoulder is good. You can do an inverse all the way down here, but just know that puts a little bit of more stress on that shoulder joint. So anyone with shoulder pain, keep it neutral and relax. Okay, Z press. Z press it. One kneeling, one back, both weights up, pressing it to the sky. On our marks, get set. Here we go. Boom, boom, alternating like a seesaw. Nice. Now, if you wanted to, you can face that palm forward to add a little extra sprinkle of salt and pepper, but still pretty much the same movement. Nice, y'all. On that halfway mark, let's switch legs. This is a beautiful segue for building up to a Turkish get-up. A Turkish get-up, recapping for y'all, starts with relax on the floor, which is our next exercise. We've done all three. Let's go to the top. Turkish get up, start like this. Same leg, same arm. Ready, set, and go. Turkish sit up. Weight above that hip. And all a Turkish get up is, how do you move from laying on your back to standing up without ever using your hands to touch the floor? Or putting the weight down. Don't do that a whole lot in life. It's just a fun whole body challenge. So if it's not fun for you, you gotta switch it up. Follow my rule here. And relax, second side. Make it work for you. Ah, shake out the arm, upper body. 40 seconds, a lot of overhead today. So remember that tricep if you want it, or switch out the pose. Ready, set, and here we go. Down, up. Second round is hard. Harder, right? Because you already been working for 45 seconds. So exhale. Push it up there. Slow and steady. Get stronger. 5 seconds to go, team. I feel ya. 3, 2, 1. And let it down. Push-ups, rows. Push-up rows. You seen it? Get your style. Going in 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Neutral wrist, neutral height. Choose your depth. Good. I am totally feeling, and you might be too, if you have the small kettlebells, the demand on the core, as you drop into that push-up. Fun stuff. Dumbbells or kettlebells, down and up, 3, 2, 1, and relax. Deep breaths, 1 foot up, leave with the side you didn't leave with the last time. On our marks, get set, and here we go. For those of you who want to switch to a tricep, you're here. This is the top of the Turkish get up. So when you're holding that weight up and overhead and trying to come up to a lunge. So how do we train to get there? We start with the components. Turkish sit ups, feet press push. Beautiful work. Getting a little fatigued towards the end. Take your time. 10 seconds to go. My goodness. My goodness. 5 seconds now. 3, 2, 1. And set that down. Last round. 3 times the charm. Turkish sit-ups. 1. Ready, set. Third round. Here we go. Still reaching. Oh, still lifting, but making it work for you. Goodness, goodness. All right, 15 seconds, y'all. Nice. By now, we're just kind of fighting for the end. Big push, big finish, 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Beautiful shoulder stability. Other side. Because you're, whenever you're lifting weight up and above the head, if it at all feels touch and go, like something, and you don't know if you can get it up again, take a break. Step back in or go lighter. Last round. Seconds. Reaching towards that ceiling. We're finishing up that last side. We're gonna have to do this again. 10 seconds to go. And relax. Press. Push up. Row. So we gotta pull and we gotta press. on our marks. Get set. And here we go. Wide feet will help that stability. Use it when you need it. Long spine. Three, two, one. That one's done. Deep press, 20 seconds per side, single or double, home stretch finish. Get it up, and here we go. Press it or tricep it. Halfway, switch it. Other leg up. Big, beautiful push. I know we're feeling fatigue at the end. 40 seconds is a long time, but we're almost done. In 3, 2, 1, relax. Set that down, y'all. We did a lot of pressing today, so take the hands behind the back, shoulders back down and around. And just let that chest expand and lengthen. Good work. Under 45 minutes. Look at that. Head to toe work. All done right there. Okay. So we're going to do a little bit of more stretching through the side body. Nope that elbow in. Knee down or extended like we did in the beginning of class. And now let's just reach and extend that arm back. Look towards that back wall, drag that thumb back, and just breathe. Having that knee on the floor with that foot anchored on the floor will give you some stability. And nice big inhales here, big, big, big. Breathe. 2, 1. Now draw that elbow back down, hold. And lift the chest. Nice inner thigh stretch. 4, 3, 2, 1, and other side. So it's kneeling. The opposite foot steps out. Lean. Nook. And reach up. Draw that thumb back. Look at it. 4, 3, 2. Okay, elbow draws it in, lift that chest, pressing gently on that bottom thigh. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Beautiful, y'all. We're gonna come on up however way feels good to you. You can meet me here in a goblet-y hold. But I am nooked in to add some support. If you want, one hand reaches like that top to the hand and look opposite. Here we go. It's kind of funky, like a sumo saying, top to the hand. Hold, then 3, 2, 1. Really opening up through that chest, other side. 3, 2, 1, stands on tall, hands behind the back. Shoulders back down and around, ear to shoulder, our classic. Looking on down, open up through that chest. Look on up, other side, ear to shoulder, look on down. Look on up. Good team, up and over. So thank you so much for joining me on that journey. We went a little bit more into the details of what a kettlebell might add or be the same as a dumbbell in that workout. And hopefully you maybe heard or saw how there's differences, but they're slight. Everything is still functional. Everything is strength-based, but a little bit of cardio too. Good, on that second side, four more breaths. Three, two, one. Three big reaches, here we go.
Gathering up, 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 up,
going to the tippy toes, getting big, and relax. Two more times.
Letting go of all the thinking, yeah? Last time, big reach, big lift, and let it go. Give yourselves a hand. Great job, team.